symbiotic plants is again, you know, the symbiotic mode of nutrition is a very interesting mode of nutrition. As I said, you know, nature is very interesting. They find out some or the other way to feed themselves. Ye nahi to wo, wo nahi to ye, you know, they find out a solution to everything. Now, they live in association with other plants. Symbiosis. What is the meaning of the word symbiosis? Symbiosis. Symbiosis. Symbiosis means, you know, living together in harmony. Living together in harmony. And, you know, what happens actually is that it is like, you know, getting benefits from each another. For example, you must have seen symbiosis in there's a symbiosis in a maybe a cow and a heron. If I can use the word cow and heron. Heron is a bird, right? Yes, Unmana, lichens are a perfect example. You can see symbiosis also in animals. You must have seen certain white color birds sitting at the back of the cows or buffaloes, you know? And so what actually happens? Cows, buffaloes, you know, and these livestock, they have a lot of ticks and insects sitting on their body. And they get very irritated, they feel very itchy, but they are unable to itch themselves, you know. So you'll see always they are moving their tail around to get rid of those insects. So yes, so what happens is that in certain birds called the heron, they sit on the back of those cows and buffaloes and they eat the insects. So what happens, it is a symbiotic, it's a beautiful partnership. It's a beautiful partnership between the two animals.
Ma'am?
Yes, Priscilla?
Like monkeys also do grooming, right?
Sorry?
Monkeys also do grooming, right?
They too do grooming, yes, but they do it on their own. They do it on their own. In case of cows, the heron, the bird, does it for it. What happens is that the heron eats away all the insects. So the cow is free of insects, right? And what the heron gets is food. So the heron is also happy, the heron is also happy, the cow is also happy. So it's a win-win situation. It's a win-win for both of them. In a symbiotic relationship, nobody loses. It's a win-win situation for both of them, right? So they live in association. Association means together with other plants. We are discussing plants now. We are getting back to plants. They share their food or shelter. Right, they either share food or else they share shelter. They are mutually beneficial, means one helps the other. Nobody is losing here. In case of cascuta is selfish. It draws away all the nutrition. So the host was losing, cascuta was winning. But in symbiotic mode of nutrition, both the plants are beneficial, benefiting each other. The relationship is called symbiosis. The mode of nutrition is called symbiotic mode of nutrition. Examples are lichens and rhizobium. Okay? So we'll study about it. Okay, this is the last portion. First, let's study about rhizobium, because you know rhizobium is a very important portion, very important part actually for bacteria, which is a very important thing which you will have to keep studying till you're in class 10 or maybe till class 11 if you choose for science. Why? I'll tell you. You know, leguminous plants. What are leguminous? See, leguminous plants are basically plants which produce legumes. What are legumes? Legumes are basically green peas, peanuts, you know, beans, French beans, you know, different kinds of beans, family of beans, which produces a lot of, gives us a lot of protein-rich food. Yes, yes, Urmana, peas, pulses, those kind of plants which produce a lot of protein. I have just discussed a little while ago in a few slides back that, you know, there are certain plants which gives us a lot of protein. Those are known as leguminous plants, legumes, dal, different kinds of dals, right? So these kind of leguminous plants need a lot of nitrogen for growing quality peanuts, quality beans, quality soya beans, right? So, you know, the farmer must be giving nitrogen-rich fertilizer in the soil. But how to convert that nitrogen to ammonia? Who will do that? So what it does is that in the roots of every leguminous plant, there are these nodes, you know, these round nodes. In these nodes resides a bacteria called Rhizobium. Please note it down. This is an important thing. It does most of the time, you know, most of the time this comes during the grades. So rhizobium, what it does is that it fixes the atmospheric nitrogen from the soil. Whatever nitrogen is available in the soil, it traps the nitrogen, it converts the nitrogen to ammonia, and then sends it from the roots to the stem, you know, and then to the plants, and then everywhere that it requires, ultimately to the fruits. Right. So in return, what is the symbiotic relationship? In return, the plant offers nutrition to the bacteria. So the bacteria also gets its nutrition. It also gets its shelter. It also gets to stay in the roots, right, in the root nodes. So this is a win-win situation for both of them. The pea plant or this leguminous plant is getting nitrogen, getting converted to ammonia, getting good amount of nutrition, and the rhizobium is also getting nutrition and shelter from the pea plant, the legume plant. So this is a symbiotic relationship that they are sharing. This is a classic example. Okay, now coming to lichens, what happens is that this is basically a, you know, an association with a fungi and a algae, lichens, right? So here what happens is that the fungus, okay, what is algae? Algae is basically green in color. So if it is green in color, that means it has chlorophyll. If it has chlorophyll, that means it makes its own food, right? So if it makes its own food, matlab it is self-sufficient. But, you know, algae are very, very, very tiny, microscopic, right? Here they have enlarged it. So it actually is not very stable. It doesn't get much place to stay. So what does this fungi do? The fungi helps it to stick onto the rocks, right? So basically, fungi helps the algae to give it shelter. Otherwise, you know, algae will not be able to stick much on the rock. And how is it beneficial for the fungi? The fungi is not green in color, can't make its own food. So the fungi derives its nutrition from the algae, right? So here also it's like a perfect win-win situation. They are like good friends. One is giving food, the other is giving shelter.